Qantas, hasn't it? Alan Joyce making a swift exit. The government under pressure to let us know why they blocked flights from Qatar that would make travel cheaper and who signed off on the decision. Acting PM Richard Marles and Opposition Leader Peter Dutton join us now. Good morning to you. Richard, to you first up. Gee, you've had a rough week, Tiger, haven't you?
It's been business as usual, and the decision around Qantas has been business as usual. I mean, we've got a transport minister who made the decision that transport ministers make, and I get that normal cabinet process is going to be confusing for Peter, given they had a prime minister who's literally doing everyone's job. But transport ministers making these kind of decisions in the national interest is how the government and the country should be run.
The captain's call, some are calling it.
I'm not sure what that means. It was the minister's call, and the minister's call in the national interest.
I think the problem is that she hasn't answered the question as to whether Alba knew, the PM knew about it before the actual public announcement. Did he know about it?
Well, she's absolutely answered the question that she made the decision, which is what transport ministers do.
No, but he did. Did he know about it before public announcement?
Well, she has made clear that she made this call because there are certain decisions which belong to ministers, and this is one of them. And that's what happened under the former government with Michael McCormack. It's what happened when the Prime Minister was the transport minister in the Rudd Gillard
years. I have the greatest respect for you, but did the Prime Minister know?
Well, the decision was made by the Transport Minister, and the fact that it was made by the Transport Minister has been made clear.
You're running for cover again.
I'm not running for cover.
Did the Prime Minister know or not?
Well, she made the decision before the Prime Minister knew, and she's made that clear. But that's how it works, and that's what you would expect to happen. But look, when you bring this back to the way in which this is impacting Australians, we need to see greater competitiveness in our skies. We need Qantas to be giving the best possible service for the lowest possible price, along with every other airline. That happens by having greater competition in our skies. That's why we've put on increased capacity. Singapore, Cathay, China Southern. And the issue with Qatar is not using the capacity they currently have. Now, we've got in place an aviation white paper process to look at how we can have greater competition in our skies. And frankly, we inherited a mess from those ops, which we've been
busy. You've got a rainbow of papers coming out. There's a Senate inquiry. Pete, you teed off on this. You certainly got some frequent flyer miles on it. Is it put to rest now?
I just don't think it is, Carl. I mean, even Richard's performance now, and again, you know, we've got the greatest of respect for him, but in question time this week, the Minister, Catherine King, could remember all of the detail about her decision-making in relation to a pretty substantial decision, but she couldn't remember anything about speaking with or the date on which she advised the Prime Minister. She couldn't recall whether she'd spoken to Alan Joyce or not, but she could recall in great detail other stakeholders she'd spoken to. It just doesn't pass the pub test. And you had Catherine King out yesterday saying, oh, it's because of, you know, what happened at Doha Airport, which was a terrible incident. But as it turns out, Penny Wong and Don Farrell, frequent flyers on Qatar and most recently accepted upgrades to first class from Qatar. So that's not the reason that it was knocked back. And obviously the Prime Minister's very close personal friendship with Alan Joyce is well known to everyone. The Prime Minister had to come back into the Parliament last week earlier this week before he went away to correct the record because he'd misled the Parliament. So I actually think after this week there's more questions than answers, and I just think Australians want a straight up answer. Richard can't answer it straight. The minister couldn't answer it straight, and hopefully the Prime Minister can do that when he gets back on Monday.
You haven't answered it straight.
Well, firstly, what we've just heard from Peter is a good old mudsling. I mean, throwing whatever he can find.
It's not hard.
Well, I mean, the opposition can come clean.
Just the facts, Richard.
Well, the opposition can come clean in terms of whatever Qatar flights they've been on.
Yeah.
So, I mean, going to there, this is not about people's personal relationships. This is about the national interest. That is the basis upon which the Transport Minister made a decision.
Let's keep rolling. The Prime Minister confirming he'll meet with President Xi later this year. Parameters of that conversation, will it get long?
Well, it will be an important meeting. It's an important part of the process of stabilising our relationship with China. You know, when we came to government, we made clear that was our intent. And what we've seen since then is the resumption of much of the trade to the benefit of thousands of Australian jobs. We've seen the formal defence dialogue be put back in place, which is so important in terms of not having any miscalculation. This is a really significant step forward.
Pete, he didn't even answer your faxes when you were in government.
Well, Carl, we always stood up for our national interest, and we'd never compromise on our beliefs, our national security, or what we fought for. So stand by all of that, but it's a good thing that the Prime Minister's going. He'll be able to raise the human rights issues, the Australians that are still held there, hopefully lift some of the sanctions that have been put in place, and we want a strong trading partnership with China, but we can't compromise on the values that that we hold dear.
All right, Pete, I thought you really turned on Richard this week, perhaps a little slightly unseemly. I mean, if you guys are going to start dishing the dirt on each other, I might have to extend the show. Hey?
Maybe we should be in the... Maybe you should demand we're in the same studio. A bit of cage fight most Friday mornings. How about that?
A bit of cage fighting.
Wow. All right, that's the headline.
You're
that's
an expert at it. I'm... Yeah,
yeah. Do you want to talk about that, the cage fighting experience?
I've got some stuff up this family story. Members in that's cage fighting.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. All right, enjoy your weekend, guys. Yeah, yeah. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Things are going from bad to worse for Qantas this week. The airline's frequent flyer program will now become a focus of a Senate inquiry after it was revealed the value of frequent flyer points has plummeted.
Let's bring in Flight Centre CEO Graham Screw-Turner now. Screw, good to see you, my friend, on this Friday morning. As if Qantas customers weren't annoyed enough, how do you see all this?
Yeah, this is quite interesting when you look at the Qantas statement that, the points are still the same value and they still have the same number of points, because certainly anecdotally, and I've been talking this morning to some people who've been trying to use frequent flyer points, and it seems that it is much more expensive in terms of the flight and generally very, very hard to get flights that are at any sort of normal times. But I don't personally use them much. As you know, they're basically FBT free, so they're pretty popular with small business people who put a lot of their expenses through credit cards and that. But the anecdotally, and I don't have any stats on this, it seems to be very hard and more expensive to actually get flights on Qantas.
Yeah, well, putting...
Can I say, this just highlights the problem with the lack of capacity, particularly internationally, particularly the UK, Europe.
Exactly.
But it's not just the capacity either. News Corp is reporting that for the same number of points that used to get you to London and back first class can now just get you one way in economy to Beirut. Is that accurate, and how's it happened?
Yeah, well, I don't know whether it's accurate, except, anecdotally, I think anyone who uses frequent flyer points has found it a lot harder and more expensive. That's what they think anyway. So we haven't actually done the numbers, and I'm not sure how we could do the numbers, but if you read the Qantas statement, it's a bit hard to interpret that. I'm not sure exactly what some of the things mean that they mean by what they say. So that really needs to be pulled apart a bit more and see what Qantas is saying there. They may be right, but it depends what they mean.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a pile-on at the moment, and my understanding is they'll come out and defend today, so let's see what happens. Now, Qantas has released a statement also about that, but also it's ongoing, isn't it, what's happening with the Qatar Airlines fiasco, can we call it that? We had Richard Marles on the show earlier, trying to explain who knew what and when, and really didn't explain anything because no one seems to know what happened. How's that all going to get resolved? What's your take?
It's an interesting question, and I think this Senate inquiry could be interesting because, everything we see, There's no good reason for knocking Qatar back. Qatar, and the airline. I know the women that were searched, really unfortunate, but that wasn't the airline, as everyone knows. It was the Qatari police. And so how the decision was made and why it was made is still a total mystery. Certainly the travel industry really wants to know about this, because this is an important direction that the government seems to be heading in, effectively trying to force up the prices of airfares rather than let them come down with more capacity.
Mm. There's so much scrutiny at the moment. The bosses are going to have to face that inquiry at some stage. What would you do in their shoes?
I'd be quite worried, I think. From what you see, what we've seen over the last few weeks, I'd be quite concerned because... you know, a Senate inquiry is not something to be taken lightly.
Screw, always good to talk to you, my friend. Let's see what happens. It's certainly been very busy since you first broke that news about 3 or 4 weeks ago. And you do a great job. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Graham.
See you at the Surf Club. See you at the Surf Club tonight, my man.